What's up guys, Arden here with Yellow House Aerial, and this weekend we have a big job going on that has multiple drones and lots of footage, and we've got a setup going that will allow us to offload a lot of footage quickly, mainly involving this Samsung T5 portable SSD, so we're going to show you the setup, just do a quick test and run through it. When we picked up the Cine SSD reader, I did do a test on an iMac Pro over at Media Lab. You can check out that video right here. I also have a video about mobile power in a vehicle. I plug my MacBook into an inverter and it runs forever. It's what I use when I'm data wrangling. I will put links to both those videos down in the description. If you're not familiar with ShotPut Pro, we did use it to conduct the original tests on the Thunderbolt 3 Cine SSD reader. It creates these wonderful reports. You can put your own logo on it. It says the title at the top. It has the status, the overall size, the checksum, the time that it was executed, completed, total time, all the details of your system. And it also shows you thumbnails of the clips that you offload, what kind of format they're in, dimensions, all that stuff. So you can triple check all your footage, which you should be watching when you offload it anyway. But it tells you everything that's there, creates it into a nice PDF that you can send off to whoever needs it, or just keep it and make sure that you know what was transferred off of a card and that way you have no question you're not going to format something accidentally. So I've got the Samsung portable SSD right here. It is 1 terabyte. This thing is pretty small, as you can see. It fits, you know, in your hand pretty well. I wouldn't say it's the most like sturdy or drop resistant thing. You can hear it's kind of more of a hollow aluminum. It's not filled with resin or anything, but it's pretty small, should be easy to keep track of. It's pretty light. We've also got our 480 gig Cine SSD here. This has 185 gigs of test footage on it that I was shooting for a different video. We have the Thunderbolt 3 reader here for Cine SSD, and we have a 2018 Retina MacBook Pro with the 2.6 gigahertz i7 processor. Now we're gonna go ahead and see how quickly we can offload 184 gigs from this and checksum it onto here. Let's see. So we got ShotPut Pro here. We just have the trial version right now, but it runs at full speed. We just haven't licensed it for this computer yet. I'm going to go ahead and put the Cine SSD into the reader and plug that in. You might hear the built-in fan on the Thunderbolt 3 reader there. Then I'm going to take the included USB-C double-ended cable and pop that in as well. So I'm going to go into this mode here. I'm going to open up a new Finder window. We're going to go over to Yellow House T5 SSD. We're going to call it test footage. Head back over to ShotPut. And there we go, test footage. So we're going to go into the Cine SSD. Here's all of our test footage. We have some RAW, some ProRes RAW, and some ProRes footage in there, a nice mix. I'm going to drag it over, call it On The Go Test 1, and go. Looks like it's gonna take about 14 minutes here to offload and do the checksums. We'll be back when it's finished. Okay, so we're all finished here. I'm gonna go ahead and eject that Cine SSD so we can get rid of the fan noise. Looks like ShotPut is just generating the reports here. So we did 184.2 gigabytes, which is 1,473.6 gigabits. And it took 725 seconds to get it done. So that's 2 gigabits per second out of a maximum theoretical 10, but that includes verifying the checksums. I know the checksum verification took about 5 out of those 12 minutes. So we're gonna go 725 minus 5 times 60. So we get 3.46 gigabits per second, which is not bad, but not spectacular. Not quite up to the maximum theoretical speed of this Samsung T5 SSD, but it might just suffice for what we're doing. 12 minutes to offload about 200 gigabytes of footage. I estimate that we'll shoot about 150 to 200 gigs before we have to offload. And if we start as soon as we're finished moving from location 1 to 2, we might have 15 minutes to get that done. So that's the setup. That's just a speed comparison, an effective 3.46 gigabits per second going from the Thunderbolt 3 Cine SSD reader to a Samsung T5 SSD using ShotPut Pro. Okay, so some not so awesome news. I went ahead and did the exact same test onto the internal SSD, and it looks like we cut down the time of 12 minutes down to 3 minutes and 16 seconds for the exact same transfer, 184.2 gigabytes. Let's just do the math here. 184.2 gigabytes times 8, 1473 gigabits, and then it was 3 minutes and 16 seconds. So we're going to divide that by 196 seconds. So that's 7.5 gigabits per second going from the Cine SSD to the internal on the Retina MacBook Pro. And it's more than twice the speed going to the Samsung T5 SSD, which is a little bit disappointing. Overall, I'm not super impressed with the performance writing to the T5 SSD, but it's an okay backup. I didn't give it enough credit initially. It does say shock resistant structure withstands falls from up to 2 meters. So I guess it'll handle a little bit of bonking around. And it will allow us to offload and make 2 verified copies of 200 gigabytes of footage on the go with no power and no other accessories. This is definitely what we'll be utilizing. Okay, fast forward, the weekend is over, the gig went beautifully. We shot a couple 100 gigabytes for the Canadian Forces, we transferred it over to the Retina MacBook Pro, and then continued the transfer to the Samsung T5 SSD. Now, in application, I realized really how big of a time difference that is, with just a few minutes going to the MacBook Pro, and then 12 or 13 minutes waiting for the same transfer to go to the T5. Now, transferring 200 gigabytes in 13 minutes is really fast compared to 5 years ago standard, but using 3.8 gigabits per second maximum write speed to this thing is really not utilizing the maximum capable 10 gigabits per second theoretical write speed of USB 3.1 Gen 2. Since purchasing and using the Samsung T5 in application, I came across the Glyph Atom 1TB RAID SSD, which is capable of 700 megabytes per second write speed, or 5.6 gigabits per second write speed, which is actually a 50% increase over the Samsung T5. Now that's huge, and it'll cut that checksum transfer process with shot put down to around 8 minutes instead of 13. So unfortunately, this Samsung T5 is going back. I will not be using it. Wah wah. With that speed increase on the Glyph Atom also comes a 30% price increase, but a 50% speed increase, so I would say in the long run it's probably worth it. So that's it for now. Hopefully that's a little bit of insight into how we transfer and backup footage on the go. We probably won't be using the Samsung T5. We'll be switching to a Glyph Atom 1TB. We'll get one of those soon enough. Hopefully this has been helpful. My name is Arden for Yellow House Aerial. If you enjoyed this, drop us a like down below. Consider subscribing to see what else we're into, and I will see you in the next video.